All of these properties are brain melting, but are they real? Could an object like this, because you know, honestly, no, they can't. The result of a rule in quantum mechanics that says electrons vehemently resist. The result of a rule in quantum mechanics that says electrons vehemently resist being squeezed together. Who wrote this? Is the hands good? Is there owls? But that's what we in the science business call a selection. What if the mass is more than 2 pocket? Oh, look at that one. Good job, Phil. Why don't you write a ton of stuff? Plenty of time for any storms barn with it. And some tip the cosmic scale.
It's good though.
Yeah, doing pretty well until I started salivating too much. All right, black holes make me drool a little bit. Open clusters are loosely bound and irregularly shaped. Such a star would be extremely weird, or really just extreme. Its mass. We think that they were among the first objects in the universe to form after the universe itself formed in the universe. This one's never ending. It's like the universe itself.
Maybe.
This episode is 45. Yeah. No edge, except right here is the edge. Unlike open clusters, though, globulars are old. Very old. Are we boring you, Nicole? Sorry.
I'm yawning all over the place.
I know. It's because there's no oxygen in this room, I think. I'm using it all up is the problem. However, galaxies really are that big, and they truly are mind-bogglingly distant. Mind-numbingly distant, yeah, mind-bogglingly. It's actually just a bubble sitting on the edge of a much, much larger, molecular, okay.
What?
My face was funny there. Got a little dark matter stuck in there. All right. I sneaked a breath in there in the middle.
You sneaked?
Sneaked.
Yep.
Snuck.
Snuck is not a word, as my wife will be more than happy to tell you.
But it's so fun to write.
Snuck.
It's fun to say.
Snuck.
Because you're referencing episode 1.
I think my glasses are crooked.
No.
Can you tell? Okay. Over time, these interactions tend to flick the lower stars out of the cluster. And I haven't even mentioned magnetars yet.
Oh, sorry, you leaned into it.
Oh, sorry, yeah.
No, you're fine to do that.
Okay.
I just need to know you're gonna do it.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna do that. By the way. Are you done? What was that noise? Is that just the water slurping in the bottle? Okay. Just outguessing a little bit there. it's a astronomy term. Excuse me, boy, that one was just waiting in the middle of that paragraph. Coffee and bacon. Neutron stars with the strongest magnetic fields are called magnetars and are capable of colossal. Black holes come in different sizes, but for all of them, the escape velocity is greater than the speed of light. So there. Just in case Nicole uses this for the outtakes. Now she's like Big Brother and we're terrified of anything she might put on YouTube.